Work your magic, Macy.
Just have to enhance. And enhance. Enhance. Oh, too enhanced. Dehance. The print matches. It couldn't possibly be anyone else.
First of all, enhance isn't a thing. Digital photos have a limited resolution. You can't just yell at a computer to get more detail. And secondly, there is no scientific proof that fingerprints are unique.
Enough, Conover. Everyone knows no two fingerprints are alike. Like snowflakes.
Oh, funny you should say that. In the 1980s, a researcher actually found two snowflakes that had precisely the same pattern.
Hey, Dingledork, let's keep it to fingerprints, okay?
Of course, save that for the Christmas episode. The no two fingerprints are alike cliche isn't science. It's just something one guy said in 1892.
My name is Sir Francis Galton. I postulate the chances of two specific individuals having the same fingerprint is very teeny tiny.
Well, he sounds very respectable.
I also invented eugenics.
Oh, God, get him out of here.
Today, Galton's hunch is common wisdom, and everyone assumes that fingerprint evidence is infallible. But it's not. Take the case of Brandon Mayfield. He was arrested for the Madrid train bombings after the world's top fingerprint experts swore that he was a perfect match for a print found at the scene.
But it wasn't me. I'm an attorney from Oregon. I've never even been to Spain.
Oh, you should go. It's lovely.
But because they believed that fingerprints told no lies, the FBI arrested Mayfield and held him for weeks.
By the way, I'm not the real Brandon. I'm an actor. Hey, let me out of here.
Hi, I'm Adam Conover. If you want to see more, click here or here. I don't know what either of these are because they're gonna add them in post. I don't know what the videos are. They just told me in the script to do this. This here's a secret for you. Hollywood's fake. Everything's added in post.